electric battery transit bus project is part of the overall umbrella of the EV Tech initiative that we have at the college. EV Tech is Electric Vehicle Technology and Education Center. It has a three-pronged mandate. First is applied research, the second is education and training, and the third is public awareness of electric vehicles.
The all-electric transit bus is a zero-emission bus and its propulsion system, simply because it doesn't have an engine on board burning fuel. An electric motor drives the wheels, but its energy comes from batteries, opposed to electric trolley buses, which are tethered to overhead lines. In this way, you don't have the cost and visual impact of overhead wires, but it does involve carrying a lot of batteries on board and a means to charge them.
The electrification of transit operations represents an item of critical importance to Manitoba Hydro. The high-capacity charging systems that are required to rapidly charge a transit bus will consume power at a rate that is equal to a large commercial enterprise. It is important for Manitoba Hydro to consider those needs when designing its distribution system and establishing the proper locations for charging.
Well, we're really a facilitator and a funder of the project. And this really stemmed out of a memorandum of understanding that we had with Mitsubishi Heavy Industries in Japan jointly to look at development of renewable energy projects and demonstration of new renewable energy projects. Our involvement was really contingent on Red River College being involved in this as well. Our view was that our money would flow through this program to ensure that we could build capacity at Red River, help build capacity at Red River, and some of the expertise that comes from both instructors and from the students.
MHI is a supplier of lithium-ion battery cell. Red River College was a member of the project, so we asked Red River College to assemble a prototype battery pack.
Manitoba has a surplus of low-cost, renewable electricity that makes electric buses here make good economical sense with an estimated $400,000 in fuel savings over the life of the bus. And transit buses are ideally suited to electrification as they travel on consistent routes with predictable energy consumption.
Given the extreme climates that we have in Manitoba, heating and cooling are critical to the success of a project such as this. Working with New Flyer, Red River College, the province of Manitoba, and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries gave us the opportunity to test electric vehicles in one of the harshest climates in the world. If we can design an electric transit bus that can survive and operate within the extreme climate that we're faced here in Manitoba, it should be successful in any other location across North America.
The bus has been out on test and simulated service for about 18 months and in various functional tests under hot and cold weather and has performed very well.
Working with Red River College has given Manitoba Hydro the ability and the access to undertake real practical research into how various designs of the all-electric bus will function and operate in real-world applications.
They supported us on the integration of the MHI batteries and been the liaison to MHI for battery performance.
Red River College has much knowledge and experience of the practical engineering.
I think it's a great opportunity for private industry to get involved and partner with Red River College. They bring a lot to the table. And these kinds of projects opens up the eyes of a company like Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, one of the largest global manufacturers in the world, to the experience and the skill sets that you can find at a place like Red River College.
One of the most pleasing factors of this project is the fact that we're able to work on a very exciting project with partners both nationally and internationally, and the support we've received from ANSWERC has helped make this possible.